for Fantas, for such a thin abans, for deep the large God, for such in the steep fit thin as one which is folky in fact, for in the flux that shown abans is banished, for we must weep joy and are as water still for the ground which cannot be bathed above any third of the breeze that can meet us, and yet doth he devise means that his banished be not extend from him now, therefore that I am come to speak of his him unto my lord, for him it is because the demon has made me afraid, and I had made said I will now speak unto the him. It may be that the him will perform the request of his hand made, for the him will hear to deliver his hand made out of the hand of the man that would destroy me and my son to death out of the inheritance of God's ancient hand made, said the word of my lord, the him shall now be comfortable, for as an angel of God so is my lord the him to disembowed, and that therefore the Lord thy God will be with thee, and the him answered and said unto the woman, hide not from me, I pray thee, the thing that I shall ask thee. And the woman said, let my lord the him now speak. And the him said, is not the hand of Jacob with thee in all this? And the woman answered and said, as I so live, if my lord the him now can turn to the right hand or to the left from aught that my lord the him hath spoken, for thy servant Joab he made me, and he put all these words in the mouth of thine hand made to fetch about this, for not speech hath thy servant Joab done this him, and my lord is wise according to the wisdom of an angel of God to know all things that are in the earth. And the king said unto Joab, behold, now I have done this thing, go therefore bring the young man Absalom again. And Joab fell to the ground on his face and bowed himself and sent the king. And Joab said, today thy servant knoweth that I have found grace in thy sight, my lord, O king, in fact the king hath fulfilled the request of his servant. So Joab arose and went to Beersheba, and brought Absalom to Jerusalem. And the king said, let him turn to his own house, and let him not see my face. So Absalom returned to his own house, and saw not the king's face, but in all Israel there was none to be so much praised as Absalom. for his beauty from Sodom and his footy and to the crown of his head there was no blemish in shame, and when he bowed his head for it was at every year's end that he bowed it because the hair was heavy on his hair, for he bowed it he weighed the hair on his head at 200 shekels after the pin's weight, and unto Absalom there were born 3 sons and 1 daughter whose name was Tamar. She was a woman of a fair countenance. So Absalom dwelt 2 full years in Jerusalem, and saw not the king's face. Therefore Absalom sent for Joab to her, sent him to the king, but he would not come to him. And when he sent again the second time, he would not come. Therefore he said unto his servant, see, Joab's field is near mine, and he hath barley there, go and set it on fire. And Absalom's servant set the field on fire. Then Joab arose and came to Absalom unto his house, and said unto him, wherefore hath thy servant set my field on fire? And Absalom answered Joab, behold, I sent unto thee, saying, come hither, that I may send thee to the king to say, wherefore am I come from? Peter, it had been good for me to have been there till now. Therefore let me see the king's face, and if there be any in it with he in me, let him kill me. So Joab came to the king and told him, and when he had told for Absalom, he came to the king and bowed himself on his face to the ground before the king, and the king kissed Absalom.